breaking news alert.
Breaking right now, the Orlando Police Department says it is investigating an officer-involved shooting.
Okay, so right now we're trying to figure out who fired a weapon and if anyone is hurt in this, but we do know it's happening right now on Mercy Drive and WD Judge Drive. So that's the area. Sky 6 right now live above the scene. You can see there are several patrol vehicles, tons of officers in the area that we've seen from the sky. There also appears to be a vehicle on the sidewalk with some front-end damage and a damaged wall there that was hit. The police department is asking people stay away from this area during the investigation.
News 6's Catherine Silver is at the staging area on Mercy and Colonial Drive. Catherine, what can you tell us?
We just got to this scene here. It's near a few car dealerships near Colonial Drive and Mercy. Law enforcement have vehicles staged in several different locations. You can see there's a heavy police presence in this intersection at Colonial Drive and Mercy. They're directing traffic in this area. A few blocks down Mercy, we can see some more lights in that area. We don't know much about what led up to this shooting at this point. I did speak to one woman when I first got to this scene about an hour ago. She told me she heard a loud noise, but didn't have much else to share with us. Now, the time that we have been here, we've seen a few school buses drive by. We have checked in with a spokesperson for Orange County Public Schools. They tell us they're not aware of any lockdowns at this time. Of course, we will keep you updated. Also, the Orlando Chief of Police just arrived here at that scene. Hopefully, we can learn more information in just a few minutes. As soon as we do, we will update you both on air and online. For now, I'm live in Orlando. Catherine Silver, getting results. News 6.
Breaking news alert.
Turned fire. The driver of the vehicle then got back in his car, sped away, and crashed further down the road, where eventually officers caught up to him, began to render aid right away, and he was transported to the hospital where he's currently there receiving treatment. We have not received an update on him. As it is in all officer-involved shootings, the Florida Department of Law Enforcement will do the preliminary initial investigation. That will be turned over to the state attorney's office, and then our internal affairs will do a thorough review of what happened. The officers did have their body-worn cameras on them, and that video is being reviewed as we speak. As soon as FDLE and the state attorney's office gives us the go-ahead to release the video, we will release that, but we will release it within 30 days, no matter what. Really, that's all we have, well, with the exception that the person who was shot appears to be a black male in his 30s. We're trying to confirm his age right now. And as usual, whenever we have a significant event of this type, the Orange County Sheriff's Office, any agency in the area, always provides assistance. So our thanks to the Orange County Sheriff's Office for the assistance they provided in this case. With that, I'll open it up for any questions you may have.
I'm sorry, I came a little late. What was the reason for the pursuit?
It wasn't a pursuit. It was a vehicle stop. An individual, the officers were on Mercy Drive traveling northbound when the vehicle on a no passing zone passed them at a high rate of speed. The officers conducted a vehicle stop. Before the officers could get out of their car, the driver of the vehicle opened fire on the officers. The officers thankfully managed to get out of the car and return fire, and they were not hurt.
The two officers in the car?
Two officers in the car.
I believe the suspect knew that it was police officers. That was
immediately, well, the officers, their vehicle is down there. I don't know if you got footage of it or not, but it's a well-lit emergency equipped vehicle. All our assumptions are that they definitely should have known that it was a police car when they opened fire on the officers, or when he opened fire on the officers.
So they likely turned lights on?
Oh, no, yeah. That's the only way that the vehicle could have come to a stop, is when the officers turned on their lights and, of course, hit their emergency equipment to try to get the vehicle to stop.
There
are multiple shots that were fired.
Was anyone else with the suspect in that car?
At this time, we don't know that, we don't think there were, but we're still reviewing video. We have video down there from one of the convenience store nearby that we have not had a chance to review, but that will be part of this process.
Did the detectives talk to the suspect yet?
Thank you.
you know, the timing of OFD was, the Orlando Fire Department was also good. Also want to give credit to the fire department who quickly arrived and began to render aid following the aid that was being rendered by our officers.
Yeah, detectives had a chance to talk to the suspect yet, if so, is there any, have you made any statements?
Again, this is very, very preliminary information, but they never had a chance to get out of the car before what we have, has been shared with us so far, is they never had a chance to get out of the car before the individual opened fire on them. Again, all that I'm telling you right now will have to be verified, and we do have to respect the fact that FDLE will be leading the investigation initially.
Were any officers injured?
No, they were not injured. Thank God they were not injured.
Was anything found in the suspect's car?
There is a weapon that was located inside the vehicle. That's part of the crime scene.
Is that the weapon that the police believe was used on them?
That is what ballistics will have to prove, whether that was in fact the weapon that was used or not.
Any reason to believe the car might have been stolen?
No, so far I don't have any information to indicate that the vehicle was stolen.
Is that a residential area down there?
So the street here is a very, very busy street. There are apartment complexes and residential areas in the vicinity, and one convenience store really nearby.
Were there other people outside?
We don't know. Of course, we're combing the area. We're trying to figure out who all may have seen some. If anyone who's watching or will see this later has any information that could help us and help FDLE do their investigation, please share that information with us.
Can you speak to how the officers are doing? Are they shaken up?
So part of our process requires them to be transported to the police station. Of course, they will be on paid administrative leave. As soon as we're done here, we're heading over to the police department so that we can check on the officers.
What's the level of experience between the two officers?
So one officer had 10 years of experience. The other one had two. With our department, I need to verify how many years he had, if in fact he worked for another agency before he worked for us.
Is this their normal area?
That I need to verify also, whether they were here on a specific, for a specific reason, or they were just traveling through the area.
Do you have a message to the public? I mean, this is a suspect who was firing officers in broad daylight.
Yeah. You know, this goes to show the inherent risk of our profession, right? And here goes to show that we would have never initiated a traffic stop if the person had obeyed the traffic laws. Not only did their actions result on that person getting injured, but also that now their family will have to contend with this. You know, a lot of people are affected by the actions that someone may take that ultimately forces law enforcement to elevate or escalate their response. It was totally avoidable. Unfortunately, it led to what we're talking about here today.
Did they return fire from inside the car or outside the car? Were they
that, so I've given you quite a bit, so I'd rather for the rest of it to come from the Florida Department of Law Enforcement. Again, I will tell you that the officers were in their vehicle when the suspect or the subject engaged them and started firing at them, and they returned fire. Absolutely, that and domestic violence calls. Always the element of surprise is on in favor of the subject who's trying to cause harm. But we also pride ourselves with the level of training that we provide our officers. Just recently, our patrol bureau that's led by our incoming chief was giving every officer in patrol has been specifically trained how to respond to a shooting incident while they're inside their vehicle. It's an investment to pull them offline, to give them that specific training, but we pride ourselves that we're always looking for, you know, the best training possible to keep our officers safe.
And also just kind of a scary situation for other people who might have been sitting in traffic when I was shooting.
You know, the fact that so many rounds were fired, of course someone else could have been injured. Again, the actions of this individual forced the officers to act, and it could have all been avoided. Thank you very much, and we'll provide updates as they become available. Okay, thank you.
All right, we've been listening to an update from Orlando Police Chief Orlando Rolone on an officer-involved shooting at Mercy Drive and WD Judge Drive. He's saying that this is all the result of a vehicle illegally passing two officers there in that area, resulting in that shooting.
Yeah, just a traffic stop that really turned into a shootout. As he claims, officers were shot at before they could even get out of the car. Again, those two officers are okay. They're uninjured. The suspect is hurt from that gunfire. We'll keep you updated on this. Still a lot more to learn about it. We'll have it here on air on the news coming up at 4 o'clock and always at clickorlando.com.